25 days ago, Kamala Harris agreed to step up as the Democrat nominee for president. In that time, she hasn't done a single interview with a journalist or held a press conference. So now the pressure's on for her to front up to journalists. That's exactly what Donald Trump did today. He held a press conference in New Jersey at his country club. The focus from him was on cost of living and groceries, which he says are more expensive than they were 4 years ago. He took aim at how Kamala Harris, through her campaign, has been characterizing him and J.D. Vance as being weird.
I don't have a lot of respect for her. I don't have a lot of respect for her intelligence. And I think she'll be a terrible president. And I think it's very important that we win. And whether the personal attacks are good, bad, I mean, she certainly attacks me personally. She actually called me weird. He's weird. It was just a soundbite. And she called J.D. and I weird. He's not weird. He was a great student at Yale.
Donald Trump spoke for around 45 minutes before he went to journalists' questions. Once he started answering those questions, you could see that there was a big lift in his mood, and he was enjoying the back-and-forth repartee with the journalists. It's a different mood from what we've seen from Donald Trump, especially since the assassination attempt against him in Pennsylvania. This could be quite the turning point in his campaign, which has been suffering from some poor perceptions around polling in key swing states. He took aim again at Kamala Harris, saying that he doesn't think she's really changed and that she should be more upfront on her policies, especially given she's been in the Biden administration for the last 3.5 years. He suggests not much will change if she does become the president.
So she is saying when she gets in, she's in now. And especially with Biden, because, I mean, he's not in the best of shape. But you know what? She's in there now. She can do anything she wants. And she's still saying, if you elect me, I'll do this, I'll do... Why didn't she do it? Here's my one question. It's the easiest question, because she complains about everything. Why didn't she do it? That's all I ask.
It was a momentous day for Joe Biden and Kamala Harris as well. They made their first appearance together since Joe Biden announced he was stepping down as the Democratic nominee for president. He seemed very happy and enthused as he took to the stage, endorsing Kamala Harris and taking a swipe at his former competitor.
The guy we're running against, what's his name? Donald Dump or Donald whatever.
Neither Kamala Harris nor Joe Biden have acknowledged the footage that was released by the Taliban this week, celebrating 3 years since the U.S. had its chaotic withdrawal from Afghanistan. They paraded some of the $7 billion in U.S. military equipment left in Afghanistan in a parade to mock America and what they left behind. Next week, we'll see the Democratic National Convention and a number of big Democrat heavy hitters come out to support Kamala Harris being formally confirmed as the Democratic nominee for president. And that's just a few weeks before the first big debate between Donald Trump and Kamala Harris. Annalise Nielsen, Sky News in Washington, D.C.